Continuing coverage now of the salmonella outbreak in tomatoes. The State Department of Health is trying to track the strain so they can figure out what's safe to eat and what's not. Action 7 News reporter Matt Grubbs has the very latest on the investigation from our Santa Fe newsroom.
At the Department of Health labs in Albuquerque, tracking Salmonella St. Paul has been job one over the past few days.
And so this clumping formation helps us identify what type of salmonella.
Samples from patients,
61 patient specimens at this time that we have run,
are matched with tomato samples.
So we know that this is salmonella isolated on this media.
And through a series of biochemical reactions, the lab is able to say definitively,
and you can see their identical banding pattern,
which New Mexicans are part of the Salmonella St. Paul outbreak. What they don't know, though, is the common factor among the tainted tomatoes.
At this point, it is really dependent on the sample that we get in on whether or not we will find the organism within the tomato.
The FDA gets all the information from the New Mexico lab, but even the feds don't know the link between the bad tomatoes. They know the kinds of tomatoes that have passed the salmonella tests, but for now, knowing which tomatoes likely don't have salmonella is as safe as it gets. In Santa Fe, Matt Grubbs, KOAT Action 7 News.
Late this afternoon, the state announced there are now 62 patient cases of salmonella in the Department of Health's lab.